Sometimes when you're making graphics in Photoshop, you might need a way to make text stand out more against the background, or simply to give your graphic a little bit more pizzazz and make it stand out more, especially if you're going to be uploading it somewhere like Pinterest, where how bright and colourful your image is will make a difference as to how many people repin your image and click through to your blog. My favourite way to do this is by adding an ombre overlay to my graphics, which is also called a gradient overlay. Take, for example, the Pinterest pin design that I've got on my screen. I've added all of the fonts that I want to appear and the text, and I've also got a photograph in the background. However, the photograph is quite busy, which means that my text is really hard to read, so this pin doesn't look amazing at the minute because nobody can read the text. To overcome this, I'm going to add a coloured gradient to the photo so that my text will stand out more, and it will also make my image much more colourful and interesting to look at. So, the first thing I need to do is make a new layer. And I want this layer to appear between my photograph and all of the text. So I'm going to click on my photograph layer down here in my layers palette, and then go to the top menu and hit Layer, New, Layer. Now I can give this a name, so I'll call it Gradient. And then hit OK. The thing I want to do next is apply my gradient. So I'm going to look down the text, down the tools palette, all the way down until I find the gradient tool here. Now you might not see this, and that's because these tools in Photoshop, all of the little icons can hide other icons underneath. So if you've got one of the other ones selected, you won't see the gradient tool. If you right click, and then you can see all of the different options. So what you might be seeing is this paint bucket instead, which is the fill tool. To switch to the gradient tool, just right click and then click on gradient tool. And now we've got our gradient. If you look up here at the top, you can see you've got lots of different colors in here to add as your gradient. And you can choose from default Photoshop ones, or we can make our own. The first one, by default, will pick up the colours that you've got selected in Photoshop. So if you look down at the bottom of your tools, you can see I've got a grey and a white, which is why this gradient is showing up grey and white. Now that doesn't look very inspiring, it's a little bit dull and boring, and I want this to be really colourful, so I'm going to change the colours. I'm going to click into this box down the bottom on the gradient line, and then this pops up a colour box underneath. If you are doing a Pinterest pin, warm colours such as yellows and reds tend to perform better than cooler colours such as blues. So I'm going to choose some nice warm colours for my gradient. I've got a yellow here, and then my second colour, if I click into this box, I'm going to make a kind of burnt orangey colour. Now don't worry if you're not entirely sure on your colours, because we can change them later. I'm going to click OK on this, and then OK again. And now I'm going to apply my gradient simply by clicking and dragging on my layer and then letting go. So that's added my gradient with those two colours, and it's automatically made that text easier to read, and it's really bright and cheerful. But I've got rid of my photograph entirely, which I don't want to do. I want a little bit of it to show through the gradient. So I'm going to go over to my layers panel and make sure I've got my gradient layer selected, and then on the right of this layer I'm going to double click, and that's going to bring up my layer style. Now I've got my opacity at the top here, and if I drag that slider down, you can see you start to see more of the photograph underneath it. So I'm going to drag it down a little bit so that the photo can just about be seen, but my text is still nice and readable. So I'm going to click OK, and now I've got a nice gradient or ombre overlay on my photo, which has made the text easy to read, but my little fonts text there isn't looking so good. So what I'm going to do is apply that same gradient to my fonts word to make it match the new colours of my pen. I'm going to click on my fonts layer, and then double click to open this layer styles again. I'm going to look down the list on the left until I see one that says gradient overlay and click that. Now I'm going to go into the box and then I'm going to choose the first one again, and I'm going to click in to the first box and I'm going to color pick a yellow from the top of the design, and I'm going to color pick an orange from the bottom. Let's make that a bit brighter and click OK and then OK again. Now that's not showing up at the minute, and that's because my blend mode is set to color burn, and that's remembering that from something I've done previously. So I'm going to click into that and put it back to normal at the top, and then drag my opacity all the way up to 100. And now that's showing my gradient on my text, but it's still not exactly what I want. I would prefer the style to be linear. And then I'm going to reverse by clicking this little reverse checkbox to make the orange at the bottom rather than the top. I'm going to click OK to apply that gradient. And now that word, which was blue before and wasn't really matching with our new gradient, now matches in perfectly. Now, I said earlier that you could change the colours on your gradient if you weren't happy with it. And one of the easiest ways to do that is to find your gradient layer, double click, and then go to gradient overlay. And that's going to apply a new gradient over the top. So just like I did before, I'm going to change the blend mode to normal, put the opacity up to 100, change the style to linear, and then I'm going to go in and change my colours. So I might try a pink and perhaps a purple. And then hit OK, OK, and then OK once more. So now we've got a different colour gradient instead of the yellow and the orange, which means that that text again that says fonts now doesn't match. Now luckily there's an easy way we can change it so that it has the same pink and purple. And the reason at this time it's easier is we applied the gradient as a gradient overlay on an existing layer rather than just using the gradient tool, which is what we did first with the orange and yellow. Now I can go to my gradient layer, right click and copy layer style. And now go up to my text layer where it says fonts, and then I'm going to right click and paste layer style. And that's added the exact same gradient to my text. If I want to change it to make the purple at the bottom and the pink at the top, I can just double click on my fonts layer, go to the gradient overlay, and just click that little reverse tick box, and it will change it around for you. So that's a really quick overview of how you can add ombre effects, also known as gradient overlays, to your designs in Photoshop.